Do you have, I'm gonna ask Manny if he has some sort of like signal that is trained in his station to like see if they can contact people or.
Yeah, can I just do like a weird owl whistle?
What does it sound like?
Like a duck.
Yeah,
you have to do it.
Wait, I gotta stop smirking.
I'm sorry.
My ability to concentrate.
The stream needs to hear this.
Can we just pretend it happened?
No.
No, it has to happen now.
Don't look at me.
Don't look at me.
Do you want me to make the noise?
Yeah, you make the noise.
Bring her in.
He's gonna be like off screen, like woo.
Yeah. I want to make sure I hear it. I stopped my music and everything.
I was all prepared to do a big loud whistle, and she just ruined it. All right.
A whistle.
No. I post up because I'm really drunk.
Come on, right, we're still in for this.
I post up in the corner and I just go woo, woo, woo. And okay. I see if anybody recall, if anybody answers.
That's not as epic as I thought this would.
Well, no.
That said owl.
It was supposed to be more epic, but he's still a little drunk.
Yeah.
Unfortunate. Roll me a perception hearing. Everyone can do that.
It's really high. Oh, shit.
Oh, my Lanta. Look at that.
Apparently, I saw something really interesting by my feet.
Apparently, I really like owls.
It's just.
You said perception?
Perception hearing.
19. I definitely heard
call. You don't have to.
Oh, no, those biscuits.
Biscuits.
Yes, I hear it.
I look towards it, right?
The funny thing is that I was asking if you had one, and you just did it anyway.
Biscuits. You think it might be the wind, but you might have heard a moaning coming from...
Oh my god, is there more zombies?
No, like a human moan, like an agonized pain.
Oh, okay.
Come from within the school that's in front of you.
I'll tell everyone else that
I heard somebody sound like they're dying in there. Like,
we should probably go school. Check it out then.
So, yeah.
I'm going to crack my knuckles and get ready to walk in. I'll put on the mask, so I'm all like freaky looking.
Yeah, I'm gonna
put the green gems in my eyes.
That was the greatest like internal conversation ever. I'm gonna put on my
Leave me alone, gravy.
Never mind.
I'm trying to save him.
Gravy, stop interrupting.
Yeah, Gravy's like talking and you're like shut up. Alright. So what do you guys do?
Shut up, Yuri.
Walk to the building.
The mask is awesome.
So you kinda prepare and you put on, you know, your combat gear. Manny, are you carrying the shotgun, or are you gonna be?
I'm always carrying my shotgun.
You're ready with the shotgun. Okay.
Yeah. That's. I got a bottle of whiskey in one hand, my shotgun in the other.
Okay.
Is this a 12 gauge, a 10 gauge, a 20 gauge?
12
gauge.
Yeah.
Does it matter what kind of? Do I have sabo rounds, slug, beer, duck?
They're basically slug. Okay. 12 gauge slugs. Your gun carries 3 shells at a time.
So my magazine carries 3 rounds, and then I have to reload. Yeah. Okay.
Standard hand feed,
and I'm fully loaded.
Switch
now.
To your improvised fighting,
right? Basically, the way that I've made your character. Some
bitch, but I want
I was
my shotgun.
Gonna say your improvised basically, fighting was way more hardcore than your shotgun.
The way that your character basically works is that you use the shotgun until you can close, and then you fuck them up melee style.
I figure I'll fire a couple rounds off, keep people's heads down, and then smash them fucking skulls. Right.
Yeah, basically you try to get to hand to hand as soon as possible because you don't have that many rounds to like spend.
You get this OP bonus on improvised weapons.
Yeah, you get like insane shit for picking up a pipe and clubbing someone with it.
All right, well, I'm going to shut up and let them get in.
Okay. So you all proceed in. Give me 1 second to switch the map.
Oh my goodness.
Hello. I'm scared.
Here it comes.
We did.
Here it comes.
Our
skulls are scary.
And you will want to scroll all the way to the bottom and a little bit towards the middle.
I see blackness.
This place is...
Oh my god, this school is huge.
Oh, you added shading! No!
Oh, what a bitch.
What's going on?
I only see black.
I fucking hate this.
Scroll out a little bit and you will see an illuminated area.
That's awful. I hate you. Versi, I hate you already.
We're like...
all of my being right now.
Hey, guys, we can't see anything. What's going on?
There's no lights.
I'll just make sure I can control my character.
Whoa.
So we came in through this door?
I'm the anime-looking dude, right?
Yes.
Oh, you changed his picture?
You guys made fun of my picture last time.
I didn't make fun of it. Did I?
No, that was just me. I think it was just me, because I thought he was an elf.
That is the wrong icon. Oh, that's... Wait, is Flower with us?
No.
No, okay. He's got the runs. He's over there moaning.
That's him moaning in high school.
Okay.
How'd you get here?
So, my rule for this, because it is a dark area, is you're only allowed to move up to your movement at a time. Because I need to keep track and make sure you don't go off to weird areas without knowing it.
Oh, was that directed at me? Because I was wandering. I apologize.
No, you're fine. You were testing out the mechanic.
Yeah.
So... how are you guys entering this building? Obviously, as you can see in front of you, there are some broken doors that normally the kids would go into to go into like the main lobby area of the school.
I'd like to roll a perception check, Zane.
Before going in?
I turned my character and I couldn't see the little square to turn him back.
Oh.
Oh my Kobe.
Do I see anything?
No, not really.
What? Oh, I was like, did he just die?
He's playing with the tokens.
Yeah. I'm sorry.
I was like, oh, no.
I'm trying to figure out what.
That's one hell of a trap.
Guardian down.
Snow. Fun thing about Boston is they actually have like watch for falling snow warnings everywhere.
Yeah.
So, I've actually saw it when I was there because I was during the record snows, partying, and repeatedly, like, I'd be walking along going to the next club, and just these fucking, like, huge sheets of death would slide off of fucking buildings and crash down right next to you. I've never seen anything like it.
Like, could it, was it just like,
it would knock you the fuck out?
Or it would, like,
ice. Like, big sheets of fucking ice, like, 4 feet long.
Don't
like just
under
sliding
the
off and crashing into the concrete.
Final Destination, that glass that cut that dude's head in half?
Kind of, except for more it was like being bludgeoned with a sledgehammer if it hit you.
That's scary.
Yeah, it was kind of scary. Like, there was a reason you didn't walk in the road.
So you guys can see my character. So, like, if I get hit with a net, I do that.
Yeah, so basically I'll do that for you.
Generally,
so.
Yeah, generally we won't do it. He will.
All right, I'm not going
to
touch it.
But usually I do, like, colors to identify creatures. Like, if there's, like, 7 hellhounds, I give it different colors so that you know which one you're attacking and stuff like that.
Oh, so colorful.
So is there any rhyme or reason to entrance now that you can't really perceive anything?
I'm assuming I'm going in first, I guess? Because I am not as squishy as the other two.
True. Manny, how are you going in?
I'm going to hang back behind the Amazon lady. I'm going to grab my shotgun. I'm going to ride right up below her leg.
Okay, so you're going in like that.
Biscuits.
Just going
to shoot between the legs.
Yeah, how tall am I?
Well, how tall are you?
Yeah.
Average?
I can choose?
Yeah, I'd never fill that
in. I'd probably be closer to myself and tall and stocky, but if I'm short and wiry, that's fine.
So we'll say like 6 foot-ish, maybe 185 pounds?
Yeah, that's smaller. I'm happy with that. That's fine.
So,
well, you're 15. I'm saying like maybe
for 15,
fully,
yeah. Okay,
you haven't filled out all the way yet.
Yurik on my live stream says to loot the lockers for poorly stashed herbs.
It's not
which
resident.
I'm cool with. Let's do it.
I don't think it's not Resident Evil. I don't think herbs do that much, right?
It might.
Okay, only if you mix them. Only if you mix
if
them.
If you mix them, that's right. And
I am totally down for
looting. Spray.
Okay.
Fuck it.
So you guys go in.
Shit.
Oh,
I thought we were going the other way.
Manny, get off me.
No, 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 I'm staying right behind her.
No, your token was on mine.
Okay. And you hear as you enter, I guess, let's see here. Zach, you would know what it is.
I'm super tempted to cheat.
Well, Zeke and Ren and Biscuits. The three of you would know this sound. It's the sound of a PA system crackling to life. And you hear a voice come over and it says, "Welcome, ladies and gentlemen. I have so much for you to see and do." And we're going to take a break.
Being like carnival-y?
A little bit. He definitely has that kind of like carny sound.
It plays like the Freddy Fazbear's jingle. Like,
what? I have a question. Creepy. What door did we go in?
The main one. Like, I figured you all filtered like that one and then the next one right to the right of it.
So we went through the front of the building.
Yeah.
Okay.
Whatever. It's where I placed you, and you guys kind of went.
So the principal's office is nearby.
Yep, yeah. That's what I was thinking.
Or the offices or whatever, yeah.
Who knows? We'll see.
Okay, and we're going to take a break right there, so 10-ish minute break. Everyone's good with that?
Yeah.
Okay.
I can make a sandwich.
Yep. Okay, all right. So you hear this voice come over the PA system. What do you guys do?
Scream and
panic. We can't do anything because if we say hello, he's not going to hear us.
I'm going to wave.
Are there visible cameras from where we are?
No.
Wait, what did he say again? Fairly, what did he say? Welcome to what?
Welcome, ladies and gentlemen. I have so much for you to see and do.
Hey, I'm going to freak out and I'm going to grab Ren's leg awkwardly.
Oh, I knew we shouldn't have done this. We should have just gone back to the police station.
I'm going to gently kick you off.
how are we seeing here? Like, what is our source of light?
Basically, it's like...
What you see on the screen.
What you see. This is what I consider as your low light from the outside and flashlights.
I'm going to holler at him, turn on the lights.
So I can't just pull out my flashlight?
No.
Darn, there goes that idea.
What's that two I see?
So the map...
It represents that area of the map.
Yeah, so like I have like a map key that I can look at that like tells me like what something is.
Oh, so like two is the entrance?
So like on my key it says two is the lobby.
Okay,
never mind. You guys don't have to worry about that because I specifically don't let you guys see that because things are different. Like, you know, two might be the room full of traps. You know, like, you guys don't know what two actually means, and I actually don't really ever use those numbers. It's just, I did not design this map. I took this map from a book I had, so.
All right, never mind then.
Yeah, okay.
Let's go somewhere.
So where are you guys headed?
Well, there's a door on our right.
I'm gonna look up this way.
Excuse me.
Oh, there's a wall. Okay. I guess I should move one at a time.
And some hallways.
Okay, so Ren, as you move up that way to your right, just on the periphery, a shadowy figure stands before you. However, this shadowy figure, it
slinks away into the darkness.
No, it like kind of stands there, but like. Like, we're normally, like, if you see a shadow, it's against something, like pressed against the wall or the floor or something like that. This is like a silhouette image of a person just standing right in the middle of the room.
I'll say hello. I'm still wearing the mask too, so I'm all like weird looking.
Right. It looks to you and you hear the crackle on the speaker and he goes, "Well, hello." And the shadow kind of like bows to you a little bit.
Ooh.
Who are you?
My name isn't important, but I am the Inquisitor. At least that's how all of my guests call me.
Am I aware of what's going on here?
Oh, you all can see him if you move up to where Ren is.
You guys are all like behind me for some reason. I thought you went a different direction.
I hadn't moved yet.
They're kind of doing the Scooby-Doo right now, where they're just following Shaggy everywhere he goes, and you are Shaggy right now.
My character's kind of freaked out. I'm hiding behind Ren regardless. Brax, shut up. Sorry.
He talks. I thought that was your girlfriend for a second. Oh. I was like, what?
It's the dog. He talks a lot.
I guess I'll just ask him, have you seen some people recently?
Oh, I see lots of people. Many, many.
What did you mean earlier?
I don't see this guy.
Okay, can I say that my impression is that if we're in an abandoned school that we know some of our people disappeared in, creepy dude talking over the PA system, probably a fucking demon.
We don't
know.
Is
this guy through this doorway? Do you say that out loud? Or is he like...
Okay. You know, I say that out loud. Like, okay. I don't know that for sure, but there's probably not just some dude who's managed to survive for all these years that took over the school.
You can see the shadow actually turns its head, which is actually very interesting for a shadow to be able to do. Like, you can actually see the head turn and look at you, and you hear him go, some might call me that.
You'd be surprised. I'd like to pull out the rosary.
Hey, can I pull out the rosary and just kind of hold it?
I'm going to cast Arcane Magic.
Oh, yeah. Okay, never mind. Well, I said he's a demon, and I'm going to shut up and hide behind Ren then.
Okay.
Can I cast my Arcane Lantern to, like, light up this place more?
Absolutely. Let's do that.
It's going to cost me 2 mana.
Okay. What's the distance that illuminates for me?
It says illuminates a 10-yard radius.
Okay, so I am going to do this for you.
10-yard radius.
That's 5 squares.
So 5 squares in every direction. On moi. I totally forgot I had that until just now. It's like, oh, this is, yeah, so useful. Fuck darkness, right? Yeah.
Oh.
Have any of us met demons that are anything but pure evil?
We've only met the one big one. And then one who was sort of like, not possessed, but...
Can you all see
we each have
brightness now?
So this guy might be open to conversation.
So basically what just happened, so you guys know the mechanics, is the light is centered on Biscuits. I also made it so that his light radius is shared to all of you. So you all still have your individual, but his is now visible to everyone. Because it's actually a burst of light coming from him.
Oh my god. If we light this place on fire, it'll light up the whole place a lot more. Gravy, probably. this is the quote.
True.
Yes.
You can see that now there's a very, very stark contrast of this shadow against everything else now that this light has illuminated outward. I'm not going to put a token, but just trust me that he's over there. Actually, I might have... I'm just going to use a token for you guys.
The vibe.
Oh, God. If he has a token, that means he's going to try to kill us.
No.
Everyone that has a token has tried to kill us. Except for even Manny. Even Manny tried to kill us. He pointed a gun at me.
You did at one point.
You did point it back at him.
It's true.
Yeah, but that's fairness to me.
Did I point a gun at somebody on for no reason, or was it justified?
It was when they basically lied to you and you captured them.
Oh, okay. Well, then, yeah, fuck them at that time. Now I support them.
Can I do a will check, I guess? Or is it perception to see, like, if he's evil or not?
Yeah, let me... Okay, I can see where the shadow is. Can I cast
I actually have an image that's almost exactly like a shadow. Hold on.
He wants to use magic missile.
Arcane awareness at the shadow. See?
Oh shit! It's huge!
It's terrifying.
Yeah. Can I?
I like when I've pre-made tokens I don't even remember making.
Always plus.
Yeah. Okay, so what are the questions?
Was wondering if I can roll like a perception or a willpower or something to see if he's like a demon or not, or like evil or something. And then Andrew was like, oh shit, something.
I straight up asked him.
Yeah.
I straight up asked him and he said that some people would call him a demon.
Yeah, but people it wouldn't be the, lie. So,
it wouldn't be the first time we've run into this scenario.
If you're going to try to discern if this guy has ill intent towards you, is that what you, I would like an emotion from you.
Yes.
What kind of emotion or feeling?
Ill intent, I guess.
Hostility.
Okay. Hostility. Ill intent or hostility. It matters.
Oh.
I'm gonna say ill intent for me. I don't know about everybody else. So.
Okay. Perception, empathy, please. You're basically trying to read.
Yeah, let me.
So bad.
I would like to roll that because I actually have empathy.
Okay.
But I want to roll for. Militant or hostility.
Or you some other emotion.
I have to just one. I can't just like roll an empathy check to see what this
guy.
No,
because I need to know exactly how to describe him to you. So that's why I narrow you down.
I don't trust him because he's a shadow on the wall.
Not even on the wall. A standing, free flowing, moving shadow. You can actually kind of see
shadow.
Through
let's,
him to
let's
behind
him.
Let's
go for ill-intent.
Ill-intent?
That
okay.
seems a bit more
okay.
broad.
I was thinking more of like, does he give off a demonic vibe or not, but ill-intent.
He's clearly a member of the Beach Boys. He's giving off nothing but good vibrations.
Oh my god.
Okay. Just the two of you? So Kira was hostility, Andrew was ill-intent, right?
No, I was ill-intent.
Yes.
Okay, both of you were ill-intent.
Yeah.
No, then,
you should split your finger.
I thought someone else was.
They can't kind of. That's metagaming if you do.
Oh, okay, I'll be quiet then.
You're fine.
That's why I was gonna go hostility, but then I was like, no, I'd actually be more towards. Yeah.
Plus, my role for perception is awful, so he might actually get something that I did not.
You can tell from the way that he's conversed with you that his language is chosen. It's not like he's thought about what he's saying to you. You can't quite tell if it's ill intent, but it is certainly mischievous. There's a gaiety that stems from him that you might be the brunt of his jokes.
Okay, I want to just straight up fire my shotgun at him. Can I like ask my compatriots if they think that's a good idea or not? Can I get
that's
like
a bad
idea.
Are you gonna like whisper that to them, or are you gonna
yeah.
like
I
say
whisper,
it like?
Like I don't trust this guy. I want to shoot his ass. I've got a no from Ren. What about the other two?
Why is Zeke and Biscuits on top of each other?
Are we really?
Your tokens are on top of each other.
No, no, I'm hiding.
I was wondering where he went.
Okay.
I want to ask how they feel about me just taking a shot at this dude.
I'm gonna go with no for now.
Okay, that's two against at least one, so I'm gonna just stay silent.
Okay. Do you guys say anything else to him?
Well, Mr. Inquisitor, whoa.
I love my shotgun though. I rack around it. It's
okay.
awful.
What's going on?
I don't like this guy.
Is there anything specific you want from us?
Well, I get lots of visitors, but, I'm a good host, and I think that any good host would prefer to show you around my house, and the shadowy hands come up, and he kind of does like a 360 spinning around with his hands out, and he goes, this is my home.
This old school?
I'm asking, where'd he come from? You're just the shadow. Where's, like, the real you?
He goes, oh, you want to know more about me? I would like to know more about you, too. I'd propose a game.
Can I just say I'm 95% sure this dude's a demon?
I'm gonna cast Arcane Awareness on this fool.
Okay.
See if I can find the point of origin, if he is, like, some sort of a... extension, so to speak, of someone else.
He is talking
to something
the
else.
Speakers, right?
Yes, the speakers are booming over you. This
yeah.
shadow just seems to be moving
yes.
almost like a ventriloquist.
So I'm gonna cast Arcane Awareness, which for 1 minute I can sense active magic within 10 yards and
okay.
make a perception test to detect details, including
okay.
Arcana, spell type,
okay.
Point of origin.
Give it to me.
Hup.
Hit me, baby, one more time.
Okay, did that match your target number?
My target number is 9, so yes.
Okay, you can definitely tell that the entire shadowy figure is magic. Like, he almost has, like, an aura around him that
shows
that he's magic.
Have we encountered any magic that's not demonic?
What Andrew so he's doing magic right now.
Yeah, so is he... Was it, yeah.
So you... Because you've seen Biscuits in action, he, for what you can tell, is a little bit wacky, but certainly not demonic. And he does magic. I will say, though, that as far as Manny is concerned, no one in your station is a magic user.
Okay, so I'm distrustful of this guy.
You have never seen magic before until you were fighting that demon. And
we're all
it's...
distrustful of this guy.
No. I'm following Ren's...
What's wrong
I'm
with
just saying.
I'm following Ren's lead, because I feel like my character is kind of taking a liking to her.
Okay, yeah. She seems okay with it, but everyone, just your kind of overall impression, it's pretty open that Biscuits is the weird one, and you don't need any empathy check. You don't need an empathy check to recognize
that. What the hell is that?
A light.
It would be a laser pointer that I got before it was illegal in the U.S.
Oh, okay. Because it looked like a giant fucking thing of mace or like a baton or something.
It's not mace. It's not
I was like, what the fuck?
Okay, so Andrew, what was the other thing you wanted to... You can detect something,
right?
It
can detect arcana, spell type, and affected area or point of origin.
Ooh, excuse me.
So you get to, like, pick one?
It says details about it, including those
things. And was there another target number that you had to roll for to detect all that, or that comes with it?
It says, for 1 minute, I can sense it and make perception tests to detect details about it, including...
Okay, so you have to do a perception for it.
Is that a minute in-game or a minute in our time?
In-game.
So, yes.
Dude, guys, I super don't want to be in this place. Like,
roll a perception check.
I don't like this at all.
And is there a... Is it like a number that I get to make up, or is there a number that it tells me that you have to rematch?
It doesn't give me one. So
okay, then I get to basically decide. That's plenty. You can tell that this is illusion magic.
Illusion.
It is something that you don't have. It's one of the new ones that I've created.
Illusion, eh?
Well,
illusion. What about the point of origin?
You are unable to detect that.
What about area of effect? Is it like the whole school? Or...
You do feel that this magic is surrounded, or like in, like it is within the whole school. Like the entire air around you hums with it.
Okay.
Also, I could say that this magic, at least from what you feel, is not malicious. It doesn't feel demonic.
And it's like, so this is like a utility illusion, or is it
an enchantment offensive type? No, not offensive. There's utility, and then there's also enhancement. It would be like an enhancement.
Okay.
So it's kind of like an extension of himself, apparently, through illusionary magic. But you can't tell its point of origin.
And he asked us to play a game.
Yes, he asked if you would be willing to play a game.
What if we say no?
I can't stop you. It's purely willing. However, I might have valuable information that you want.
Such as?
I don't trust you.
Where the food is? Where are all the survivors, if there are survivors?
What if we just search the school and come find you and beat it out of you?
You could do that, and I could burn down a majority of the food.
I think he's fucking.
And that one's for free. And he kind of giggles at that.
I think I need to hear the giggle, please. I need to hear the intent in the giggle. I don't like this, guys. I think we should get out of here while we still can.
Well, wouldn't you be giving up on the quest to find the missing runners?
I mean...
Yeah. Aren't you on a quest to find the missing runners? I know where they are.
Well,
I know where all of them are.
Fuck this dude and his creepy shit. Let's wander through the high school. If we find anything we think we can't take down, we'll take off. Until then, let's just start blowing some shit up.
Well, let's not promise to play his game, but let's see if we can get him to tell us about the game.
No, I say screw him. Let's just wander around, ignore this guy entirely.
You want to know the game?
There's traps.
I'd be happy to tell you about the game.
There's going to be a shit ton of traps if we do that.
I'd be happy to tell you about the game.
I will gladly wander ahead and risk the traps.
Alright, what is this game you
let's,
have to
let's
offer?
Let's just hear him out, at least.
I feel like he's not going to say anything that's not bullshit. He's going to try and lie to you guys, get you to do what he wants.
It's one of my favorite games. Deception. It's one of my favorite games.
Yeah, I don't like this guy or his games.
For every question that you ask, I will tell you the truth. And every question that you ask, I will ask one in return. And you must tell me the truth. But me being the Inquisitor will probably know if you lie. And if you lie to me 3 times, I will kill everyone in here, including you.